welcome, Al. Just tell us a bit about Chailey Heritage first, because you do some great work with young adults with complex needs.
Yeah, so we are an organisation that caters for children and adults with very complex medical needs, physical needs and learning needs. We're a non-maintained special needs school as well, so we have a school, we have school environments, we're very much educational based. With the link that we have to the NHS as well, it means that we can cater for children that are kind of on that top end of that disability spectrum that would need nurse input, that probably wouldn't be able to cope in another environment. So we are that kind of area of expertise where children who, with those most complex needs, can come and learn safely.
How are you coping with the coronavirus crisis?
It's affected the foundation quite a lot. From a school perspective, we've stayed open as a school just because we have residential children and users on site. So we have children that live at Chailey Heritage. So therefore, we can't close. We're staying open for those children. There aren't as many of them, obviously. We've got a roughly sort of 20 students that are still coming into school. The staff that we have that would look after those children has dropped dramatically. So they're working one-to-one with those children, which is good, sort of reducing the amount of people that are coming into contact with the children. Because of their medical needs, it's very important that this is done, and this is done in a correct way. But it's had a big impact. It's had a big impact on the way that the day, you know, the school day would normally run for these children. But hopefully we are still catering for their needs and keeping their education up during this really trying time.
How do you guys stay positive? How does the team stay positive, both the young adults but also the staff at Chailey Heritage?
I think setting challenges is the main thing. Setting things that the children can do from a day-to-day basis. As I said, we only get 1 hour a day that we're allowed out to be active and things like that with these children. It's very easy just to sort of shut yourself indoors during these times and hide away. And even though that is very important, I also believe getting that physical activity, especially for our children that are mostly in wheelchairs, so they're sedentary a lot of the time, it's particularly important for those guys to get their bodies moving and to stay active, not just for their physical health but for their mental health. So I would say setting realistic goals and translating that over to the carers so that they can motivate the children to reach those goals.
Yeah. Have you got any advice for carers that are looking after young adults, particularly those with complex needs, because this is a challenging time for a lot of people, isn't it?
So the two ends, really, I'd say practically keep clean, keep safe, stay away from others, do the activities, but also on the other side of things, make it engaging, make it fun, make it a positive experience for the children, so they look forward to that hour of the day of getting out and enjoying activity.